Take a look at this question. Would you prefer more places to sit or more places to park in downtown West Palm Beach? Parklets are making a comeback, allowing restaurants to expand their sidewalk area, and city leaders are promising it will not take away from parking in the downtown area. The Now's Alana Quillen joining us here in studio to explain. Alana?
Well, when you turn a parking space into a social or a green space, that's called a parklet. You may have seen them in cities like New York or Montreal. West Palm Beach did a six-month test, and now city commissioners are moving forward to make these parklets a permanent part of Northwood and downtown West Palm Beach.
You know, the downtown area is growing in leaps and bounds,
and the sidewalk is growing too.
Let's face it, we're in Florida. The weather's perfect. Let's expand the sidewalk.
City commissioners are moving forward with parklets, a parking space converted into a social or green space.
There's so many parklets to be made.
Downtown Development Authority hired artist Cheryl Moriente and her husband Bijou to create parklets for a test project in downtown last year. They've done similar projects in Miami.
Designed something that was modular, easy to put in and out. In case there was a hurricane, we could actually take the parklet out within 30 minutes.
Field of Greens,
you said no tomato,
was part of the test.
We loved it. It was wonderful. It's inviting. It's cozy. It just adds a whole different dimension, I think, to Clematis Street.
In the new ordinance, restaurants can turn a parking space into extended seating.
And the restaurants are the ones that are going to be responsible for paying for it, not the taxpayers. So I think it's a win-win.
But what about taking up the already existing parking spaces? To prevent parklets from eating up too many parking spots, only one parklet will be allowed on each side of the block, with a max of two per block. And it cannot take up disabled parking spaces.
Most cities are extremely expensive to park. Here it's very cheap. Across the street by the library, it's $1 an hour.
Plus, some restaurants tell me they're already planning to partner with other businesses to split the cost of a parklet.
It's all about community here.
City commissioners are expected to pass the parklet ordinance at their next meeting in January.
The Downtown Development Authority told me the average cost to build and install one parklet is $3,900, which again will be paid for by the businesses. Those who want to build and install a parklet will have to apply for a two-year permit. Designs would also need to be approved by city urban planners before anything can be built. For the Now South Florida, I'm Alana Quillen.
Alana.